morning and welcome to Never Too Old to Rock. I'm your host Jim. You can call me Jim. If you're new to the channel, welcome. If you're already a subscriber, you're fucking awesome. If you just clicked onto this channel just to see what it's about, well, it's reactions to rock, metal, 80s music. I'm sorry in the 80s stuff, because not all of the 80s was bad. Not all of it was cheesy. There were some good tracks, and I enjoyed them, and it brings back some good memories for me. So I throw in every now and then just to sort of, you know, remind me of some good memories. And that's what the channel's about anyway. Also, if you could do us a big favour, you'd be really helping me out. Would really appreciate you just hitting that subscribe button and making my day better. If it wasn't for you guys, I wouldn't do this channel. So, please, feel free to hit that subscribe button. And if you've got a request, hey, just leave it in the comment section. I guarantee I will do it for you. Okay? It's my promise. If I can't do the video, because YouTube tends to block a lot of them, then I will find another way of doing it. So, you know, please, you know, feel free to do that. But what have I got for you today? I had mixed feelings about doing this band. At one time I really liked them. Back in 1986 when they released their first album. I liked them back then. I thought they were alright. As time has gone by and I've heard other bands, I still like it, but not as much. It's Bon Jovi. Now, say what you want about Bon Jovi. The first few albums were brilliant. I'll admit that. But over time, they didn't really have that much effect on me. Not like when they first came, you know, when they did their first album. So I wasn't sure whether I was going to put this band on this channel or not. But after consideration, they're part of rock and metal, so I have to, you know, it's written in the rules, you know, if it's considered rock or metal, you have to do it. So I'm going to. It's Livin on a Prayer, 1986, from the Slippery When Wet album, which to me was their best album. Now I'm sure you've probably heard this, everyone has, but I'm still going to do it. You might see me sort of miming the words, because I do know that the song off by heart. And it's a good karaoke piece. I won a karaoke competition back in the 90s doing this song. One sort of like a bottle of champagne and a t-shirt. I didn't care. I was having fun. So, yes, this is what we're going to be reacting to today anyway. So, without further ado, let's do this. Bon Jovi, Living on a Prayer. Like I said, I started off as a Bon Jovi fan. I did. Mainly because I was what, 11, 12 years of age, and didn't really sort of understand. I just, I just liked the music. And but as I sort of progressed into other bands, they, I'm not making this as a slight on Bon Jovi fans. I'm sure that there's loads of you out there, and I'm not going to take the mick or anything like that, or say anything derogatory. I'm just going on what I sort of was sort of going through when they, released their first album. And I enjoyed the first album. I thought it was brilliant, But then I started listening to Maiden and Guns N' Roses and Metallica, and it just shifted me, and I will be honest, it's been a long time since I've heard anything from Bon Jovi. Yeah, I think the last Bon Jovi album I heard was probably Crossroads. They were all right at the beginning. It's just that when you progress into other bands, it changes you sometimes, and it happens. You can't help it, Don't get me wrong, I'll always be grateful to bands such as Bon Jovi for sort of helping me sort of transition to other bands. Yeah, that's like I said, I wasn't too sure, because a lot of people will say, "Oh, you've got a sellout for fucking doing that song. Why do you do that?" And I was sort of, I wasn't sure whether I was going to do it or not, because I can't. One thing I can't abide is the fucking trolls that come on the channel and start bad mouthing you and things like that. I've had quite a few of them, and I've come to the realization that they don't matter. I could use stronger language, and call them what I think, exactly what I think. But I'm not going to do that. But these people know who they are. So I'm ignoring them, and I'm just going to do the, I've done the reaction, and I've said my piece, and I hope you understand that I'm not, slagging them off or anything like that. It's just that, if you wanna sort of, you can't just stick with one band. Sometimes you have to. There are a load of bands out there that are fucking awesome, and when you're sort of, you have to sort of experiment with other bands. Is it, otherwise you just don't know. you ain't getting a full, you know, full range. And Bon Jovi's kick-started that off for me, and I will be eternally grateful. So that's why I've done the request. Whether you call me a sellout or whatever, I don't really care. If you think that way, you can kiss my ass. How about that? I'll put it that way. And that's my take on it. But I hope you enjoyed the video. Please leave a like. Please subscribe. Please check out my videos. Come on, you know you want to. Deep down you do. I know you. Don't ignore that itch at the back of your neck. Every itch needs to be scratched. Just do it. And I shall catch you all in the next one. Peace.